Hello, Billy Ashbaugh here, drummerconnection.com, and welcome to Swing Introduction. If you're just getting started in swing, you're in for a trip. This is a lot of fun. A couple of things right away, real important. Obviously, swing is set in triplet world, so you really have to get a good grip on subdividing eighth note triplets before you move on with this. When you have that down, you also have to really pay attention to dynamics. In swing, the right hand on the ride, or left if you're left-handed, I should say just the ride, is the main voicing. That's where you want to concentrate on putting all of your time, and that's going to be the loudest voicing on the kit. Unlike pop rock or funk music like we've been doing, where the kick and snare sort of carry it, it's the ride now. So it's a lot of different things going on here. So let's look first at the ride. The typical swing ride pattern, which is not written in stone, but it's a great way to learn the concept, is going to have a quarter note on beat one, first and last triplet of beat two, another quarter note on three, and then again, first and last triplet of beat four. Okay, as always, relax. Remember, you're going to really concentrate on time and getting that to feel really nice. Understanding the triplet pulse is super important. Now, all we're going to do is get the left foot involved. The left foot just does typically beats two and four by just using your left foot only, not striking it with the stick. And you want to, I'd recommend in the beginning, go ahead and get used to getting the left foot up and getting a nice two and four. So that's sort of, that's almost what the snare does for pop and R&B and funk music. It gives the rest of the band something to really glue to. It was almost like a backbeat. So we're going to bring in now two and four on the hi-hat with our ride pattern. Okay, it's time to get the bass drum in the mix. Did I mention dynamics? Okay, we're going to feather with the bass drum. Such unlike probably what you've done so far. I prefer heel down. You can do heel up. Typically, heel down helps the whole feathering process. Feathering means very lightly tapped. Almost, it's felt more than heard sort of thing. So all the bass drum's going to do is just steady corner notes underneath that very, very lightly, and that sounds like this. Now let's get the snare drum in the mix. To sort of introduce this to us, we can do a number of things. You can play two and four as a side stick on the snare and create a nice little swing groove. You can play just two, or you can play just four. So experiment with this, but I'll let you hear what two and four sounds like. Okay, now we're going to have some fun with this. We're going to take the left hand out, keep the ride, the feathering kick drum, and two and four nice and steady and consistent. And what we're going to do basically is just practice a series of different swing or triplet patterns on the snare drum dynamically. In the beginning, let's do them very lightly with the tip of the stick sort of in the center of the snare head. Now, I've included a PDF file that I want you guys to download, and on it is going to be a page that has 20 different one bar rhythmic patterns, all involving triplets. At this stage, we're either going to do just the quarter note or the last triplet or the first and last triplet for now to get used to this. So what I want to do is get started with that. So let's look at the first rhythm. Okay, what we have for the first measure or first rhythm is three quarter notes for beats one, two, and three, and then simply the last triplet on beat four. Now, as you get into this stuff, I don't want you to just start at the top and read down, the entire page, unless you can do that flawlessly, and then by all means move on. But I think looping is very important. Looping or repeating, very, very important. So let's stay on that first measure until it feels comfortable over and over again. So I'll let you hear that four times. Okay. Okay, for the second example, let's move down to number 9. What this does is you've got a quarter note on 1, you do the last triplet of beat 2, again, the last triplet of beat 3, and then another quarter note on beat 4. I'll loop this for you, let you hear what this sounds like 4 times. I'm going to share one more example with you. Let's go down to number 19. This one has the last triplet of 1, the last triplet of 2, we've got a quarter note rest, meaning silent, on beat 3, and then again a quarter note on beat 4. So you're going to play that over and over 4 times until it feels good, and it sounds like this. Okay, now don't forget, download these PDF files at drummerconnection.com. Very important, you need this sheet in front of you. You have to be able to look at this and loop it over and over before you can move on. So I want to share with you a great exercise, a wonderful teacher and a good friend of mine, Ronnie Siaga. He turned me onto this years ago. So what you're going to do is, just like I did, 4 bars of any given pattern, and then on beat 4, no matter what's written on the snare drum, play the last triplet of beat 4 as a rim shot along with a crash, and then 2 bars of time. Go back to just letting the left hand relax and just feathering, keeping time for 2 bars, and then repeat the process. So you've got 4 bars of the groove with the accent sort of coming out of it and just hanging out for 2 bars, and then repeating that. So I'll give you an example. Let's look at number 7 this time. Number 7 does 2 quarter notes for 1, and then again for 2, and then it does the last triplet of 3, and again the last triplet of 4. Okay, same thing, same exercise, 4 bars with 2 bars of just playing time. This time let's look at number 15. I like this one. All it does is play the last triplet of every beat. One final example, number 20 on your download sheet. This plays quarter note on 1, last triplet of 2, has a quarter note rest, meaning silent, on beat 3, and the last triplet on beat 4. Welcome to Swing. Hope you enjoyed that. A lot of stuff going on. Did I mention dynamics? Very important. We've got the ride, really the focus of what we're doing with this groove. You've got your bass drum, really light feathering and just keeping time with 2 and 4. And basically your left hand does all the coloring, all the movement, and just sort of does all the ad-libbing. I can't say this enough. You have to be very patient and to loop this stuff over and over again. Don't forget to download your files at drummerconnection.com. You have to have that sheet in front of you and stare at it like a bouncing ball and just get used to seeing what it looks like on the paper as opposed to what it sounds like while you're playing it. So remember, be patient as always with this stuff. Have fun and check back. We got a lot more swing coming to you.